Sony officially released its second state of play. And the question looming over the entire community is, was it better than the first one? Or, better yet, is it now officially better than Inside Xbox? Let's look into it. What's up, peoples? It's your boy MM2K back again with another one. Hey, yo, can y'all do me a huge favor? Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Rock those bells for notifications, please, so you know when your boy's dropping these doses. I appreciate all of y'all straight up, because I ain't too proud to ask. You know what I'm saying? As my bro, Post Up, likes to say, let's talk about it, man. Sony's second state of play, May 9th, 2019. It's already gone. It's in the history book. For those of you that haven't seen it, it was officially around 10 minutes runtime, you know what I'm saying? There may have been some commentary afterwards, you know what I'm saying, but I didn't stick around and listen to that. I just went and listened to the material, which was the game showcase, and turned it off. But here's the thing. If you want to watch it, go ahead and watch it. But if you didn't, here's a quick rundown of the stuff that was shown. And this is a rundown presented courtesy of VG247, okay? So in their article, they write, Sony's second State of Play stream kept things short, but a few interesting new games and one big title we've been waiting on for some time were shown off. State of Play, Sony's answer to the Nintendo Direct, played things pretty low-key in its second outing. While the first State of Play focused largely on VR, this one mixed things up a bit across its brief 12-minute runtime, as they allude again, which 10 minutes of games being shown and then maybe a couple of minutes of follow-up talking. But they also say we got a mix of new, smaller titles and new trailers for bigger games that we've been waiting on for some time. The three highlights of the show as they continue, all of which we've written separate posts about, were the Monster Hunter World, Iceborne trailer, the Medieval trailer, and the Final Fantasy VII Remake trailer. These were all games we knew were in development, but it's good to see how they're coming along, particularly Final Fantasy VII Remake, which we'll apparently hear more about next month. Now, and I decided to read that article because that pretty much sums it up. I mean, again, if you want to watch it, go ahead and watch it, but I'm going to give you my honest opinion. The show was not exciting in the least. To me, it was another waste of time. Even for 10 minutes, you bring the hardcore together, even for those 10 minutes, when really the only thing that was noteworthy was the Final Fantasy VII Remake status. No release date on that was presented. I mean, come on, they tell you that they're gonna follow up with more information in June? Now, I'm not 100% sure at the time of this recording, but I think this is going to be a multi-platform thing anyway, so it'd be different if this was exclusive. But again, this is you're stringing us along with information on something that's going to be at some point in time multi-plat. I mean, I know there was a lot of noise about Medieval 2, but that's a remake. I mean, honestly, both of these could have got separate shorts on the PlayStation channels, you know what I mean? And you could have called it a day. The show was complete and utter garbage. Okay, and this is coming from someone that, yeah, may be an Xbox enthusiast, but I have well hammered Inside Xbox over and over again. But here's my point, and here's the overarching question that everybody presents in the community and that needs to be answered. Even though we're only two episodes in, is State of the Play for PlayStation better than Inside Xbox? Here's my answer. Simply short, no. I get it. Everybody's busting out the seams because it's so taboo to say anything Xbox is better than PlayStation. And see, you're looking at it the wrong way if you look at it through that lens. Both shows are horrible. Both shows are not effective. But here's the thing with State of Play opposed to Inside Xbox. Inside Xbox is bad because the execution is bad. And more importantly, they are not showing the content yet that gamers want to see. However, Xbox fans are still getting E3s. They're still going to be able to partake in the FanFest ceremonies. And even though the execution may be bad and it's filled with cringy jokes and remakes of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air openings, there is noteworthy news embedded within the show. Again, it's just presented horribly. State of Play, on the other hand, is just horrible. It's a waste of time. It's beyond horrible. It's just a waste of time. And if you take into consideration that Sony fans have not gotten a PSX, they have not gotten all of the other PlayStation shows, the Paris game shows, they are not getting an E3. They're pretty much being mum as far as anything extravagant or anything fanfare related for the PlayStation faithful in 2019 to satisfy investors. To me, that makes the State of Play show even worse. This is supposed to supplement all of the fanfare that Sony fans are used to, way more than the Xbox fans. So again, to rehash and in full context, I am not saying that Inside Xbox is a great show and State of Play is horrible opposed to a great show. Both shows are horrendous. But if you want to get technical, yeah, I think State of Play is just a worser giving than Inside Xbox. With that said, I am not clapping like a baby seal for Inside Xbox, because comparing the two shows is like comparing a shit sandwich to a cup of piss. And at the end of the day, both of these piss poor showings are doing a disservice to gamers, period. And that's it from your boy MM2K. Yo, let me know what you think about what I had to say in the comment section below. As I always tell y'all, y'all can come with me or come at me. It don't matter to your boy. But if you like what I had to say, you know what I'm saying? Follow me. You can do so by clicking the links below. You can catch me on the corner every boulevard. You know what I mean? In addition to that, I do a show with your people. Snow Bunny, Dirt Griggity, Neethles. It's called Scram Punks. We do it every Wednesday, either 9 or 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Check out Dirt Griggity's channel or just check out the previous on-demand shows in the link below for Scram Punks. And last but not least, give it up for my peoples, the Broadband Bullies, man. We doing the damn thing, man. We got shows and innovation just popping everywhere, man. Just stay tuned. Check out that Discord link, man, if you want to keep up with the stuff on the inside, man. That Discord link is crazy. It's live in there. Man, check out our merchandise, man. Click the link for our merchandise and all our gear. It's fly. And as always, you have a wonderful, wonderful gaming day.